up, world? It's your boy, Pastor Ahmad, man, with the Hip Hop Service Devotional, man. Thank you for continuing to pull up and be a part of our online campus. We pray that the content that God has been leading us to drop has been a blessing to you. And if it has, and you haven't done it yet, please click that like button and click that subscribe button so you can continue to receive the content that God is leading us to provide, man. Today, man, I want to focus on handle your priorities, man. Handle your priorities, man. I remember when I was a kid, man, I might got home from school, man, and drop my bag, you know what I'm saying, and run out and go meet the homies at the park, man, and we up there playing basketball, playing some football, you know what I'm saying, or I might go to one of my friend's house and playing video games, and man, she might be gone for a couple hours, but man, I would get home sometimes, man, and my mom be like, boy, you need to handle your priorities. You know what I'm saying? And I was, you know, and usually when she said that, it was because I didn't clean my room like she asked me to, or because I hadn't done my homework that I was supposed to be doing when I got home and things of that nature. And so, man, she wasn't saying don't spend time with your friends, don't have fun with your friends and in healthy relationships. But what she was saying is don't put the wrong things first. You know what I'm saying? And that's basically what priorities is dealing with, is that sometimes we put the wrong things first. And in this case, sometimes we put a lot of things before we put our relationship with God. Our relationship with God needs to be at the top of the list. You know what I'm saying? Our relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ needs to be that number one priority, because it's through that we are better in terms of our relationships with others. It's through our relationship with Jesus Christ, man. And so we're going to take some time to look into the scripture real quick, man. Mark chapter 1, verse 35. This is a little piece about Jesus and the way that he handled his priority. It says this: "And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place, and there prayed. And Simon and they that were with him followed after him. And when they had found him, they said to him, 'Everybody is looking for you.' And he said to them, 'Let us go into the next towns, that I may preach there also, for that's why I came.'" And so, man, shoot, man, we're going to look at that. It's a few points I want to raise from that. And the first point is that, man, Jesus was intentional about spending time with the Heavenly Father. Jesus was intentional about spending time with the Heavenly Father. Where do we see that at? We see that when it tells us that he got up and then he went out. He got up, you know what I'm saying? He got up early. Bob said he got up early in the morning, great while before day, and then he went out, man. You know, even when I think about just the mechanics of waking up, you know what I'm saying? I have to be intentional about getting out of the bed. I have to, you know, raise up out of bed, turn to the side, get my feet on the floor, stand up and go. You know what I'm saying? That don't just happen. That won't just happen, you know what I'm saying, by me just sitting there and thinking it happened. I have to be intentional. And in the same way, in order for us to grow our relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, in order for us to grow in our spiritual walk as a Christian, you know what I'm saying, we have to be intentional. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what intentional needs to look like for you, but I'll give some examples about what intentional looks like for me. You know what I'm saying? One of the ways that I try to be intentional by spending time with God when my day starts, and I prefer to do it when my day starts because in my mind, I don't know what the day holds for me, but I do know God knows. And if I tap into him, he can give me the strength, the direction, the peace, whatever I need, so that whatever's going to happen that day happens, that in a strange way, because I spend time with him, I'll be prepared for it. And that's why I prefer to spend time with God in the morning, you know what I'm saying, to set the atmosphere for my day. So one of the ways I do that is that, man, I get up about 30, 40 minutes, sometimes an hour before my kids wake up. Because when they wake up and getting ready for school, they are, dad, what's for breakfast? What, you know what I'm saying? All that stuff. And so, man, so I like to spend time with God before my day, before my kids get up. You know what I'm saying? That's some prayer time. There's some time in the Word. You know what I'm saying? Some time just listening and seeing what is God saying to me through the Word. What is God maybe speaking into my spirit about some decisions that I'm making, or like some things I have to do that day. Whatever the case may be. That's one of the ways that I'm intentional about it. Another way is that, man, if I don't wake up on time, man, another thing I do, bro, is after I drop my kids off from school and I'm going, driving into work, man, I will cut the radio off and just pray and kick it with God, you know what I'm saying, in the car ride to the job, you know what I'm saying? But regardless of the point is that I'm just trying to be intentional. I'm trying to do this thing on purpose so that I can live in his purpose for my life, man. So that's the first point. Be intentional, man. The second point, man, is that Jesus isolated himself. You know what I'm saying? Bible says that he went to a solitary place. Solitary mean it was just, you know what I'm saying, him and the Heavenly Father. You know what I'm saying? And so why is that important? Because sometimes, bro, when we got too much going on around us, we're not able to focus, you know what I'm saying, on what God may be saying to our spirit, what God may be revealing to us through the scriptures, what the peace that God is trying to pour into our lives as we pray, you know what I'm saying, to the Heavenly Father, you know what I'm saying? And so, man, it's all right to isolate yourself in your time with God, you know what I'm saying? It's all right to press in to him with just you and him. That's crucial. Because in order for me to be the best husband that I can be, I need to be the best follower of Christ that I can be so that I can love my wife the way that Christ loved the church. In order for me to be the best father that I can be, I got to spend time with the Father to refine me and to show me where I fall short as a father and where I need to zero in and be more attentive to my kids. You know what I'm saying? God has to reveal that to me because sometimes I miss it. Sometimes I miss the mark, man. You know what I'm saying? God's got to reveal to me how to be a better employee at my job, how to add value with what God has called me to do. You know what I'm saying? He's got to show me those things, you know? But if I don't isolate, if I don't shut off all the distractions and the other voices that compete with the voice of God, then I'm going to miss out. You know what I'm saying? And that brings us to the third and final point, man, is that after Jesus was intentional, after Jesus isolated himself, the next thing we see in this passage was that Jesus, after that isolation time with the Father, that he was focused on being obedient to what the Father had told him in that time of prayer. You know what I'm saying? Where you see that at, Pastor Mod? Man, I see that at verses 36 through 38, because Simon and the rest of the disciples came to him and was like, yo, Jesus, bro, like everybody's looking for you. And the reason why they was looking for him was because the day before, man, Jesus had it popping, bro, with the miracles, man. He actually was at Simon's house the day before. Simon's mother-in-law was sick, and then Jesus healed her. She got up and served the whole house, and people were just talking about how, you know what I'm saying, Jesus had healed. The next thing you know, people start pulling up to Simon's house, getting healed of all kinds of other sicknesses. There were people who brought their friends or family members who were demon possessed, and Jesus cast out demons out of them, bro. So it was a day of miracles the day before, and Simon and them was so geeked about it, so crunk, that they came, and other people came who had probably heard about it and had came to either get a miracle or to see a miracle be done. So they was looking for him too, you know what I'm saying? So that time with the Father was very, very important that Jesus took, you know what I'm saying, before everybody got up. Because what we see in this passage and what we see in our everyday life, that if we don't hear what God wants us to do and if we aren't committed to doing what God wants us to do, then there are other people in our lives that will tell us what they want us to do. You know what I'm saying? And it may not be a bad thing. I mean, it's not a bad thing that Simon, man, wanted other miracles to be done or other people to be healed. That ain't a bad thing. But that may not be God's purpose for your life at that moment. You know what I'm saying? God had another mission for Jesus to go forward and preach the gospel in some other towns who needed to hear about the good news of Jesus Christ and that the Messiah had come, you know what I'm saying, to save the world from their sins, man. And so, you know, we just got to be mindful, bro. You know what I'm saying? That if we don't hear from God, we'll wind up doing what people want us to do instead of doing what God wants us to do. That if we aren't intentional about isolating ourselves and pressing in to some time with God, and that don't have to be no extensive time. You know what I'm saying? That could be 15 minutes of focused quality time. You know what I'm saying? 20 minutes. It don't have to be no hour, no, like, we gonna tarry here and pray here all night. It don't have to be that. But if we start with a little bit at a time, because a little bit from God will go a long way in our life and in our journey, man. So, man, I just want to encourage you. Be intentional. Isolate yourself. Be focused on what God, through his scriptures and through the Holy Spirit, is trying to say to you by that faith that we have in Jesus Christ. Amen. So, man, be encouraged. Go forward. be who God has called you to be, man. Man, Father, I pray that you will bless everybody that listen to this, Lord. Whatever nugget they need to take from it, Lord, remind them of it throughout the week and help them to do their best to do what it is that you're calling them to do in this season of their life journey. In Jesus' name, amen. Man, God bless you, man. Thank you for your time. See y'all soon, man. See y'all with the next post. Be blessed.